everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. It's a fresh start throughout the league here in week one as these two teams have high hopes for the season ahead. It's the Titans going up against the Ravens. With that, let's call in our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis, with this opening week matchup.
Larry, thanks. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Inner Harbor at M&T Bank Stadium in Baltimore, Maryland. Today, it's the opener of a new NFL season between the Tennessee Titans and the Baltimore Ravens. Get this one up to the 26. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
A one-yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
Now Hundley. Side here, and that's complete. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. First down coming there on the intermediate passing play. That's been a point of emphasis, they told us in practice, using those medium routes to keep the defense off balance.
And it wasn't just them telling us. We got to watch them practice it and work on it because they've been trying to fine-tune it and get it.
And now the ball's out. Fumble near midfield. And they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line. And without a doubt, not the way they pictured that opening drive unfolding.
No, they were making progress. They weren't exactly in high gear, but they were making a few yards along the way. And now that they've coughed it up, you got to go back to the sidelines and regroup a little bit.
Hurry up, here we go.
Now a play fake here on first down. Buying time to his left. And his first look is incomplete. The wide receivers, often a very, very talented group, and that's the case here.
And they don't mind showcasing it either. Those guys love to be flashy, love to make big plays out in the open field. They will attempt to do so in this game.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. That catch good for five. It's third down. A look at the defensive starters for Tennessee.
Brandon Marshall, no, not the wide receiver, a quality linebacker who can cover very well.
5 yards to gain here on third down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. To punt it away on fourth down, here's Drew Kayser. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. Out come the Titans now. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about, what, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And those are so many drills focus on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to simulate game situations. Doesn't always work out, though.
And the big boys up front in the trenches, what do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
Throwing left side, it's complete. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. And a nice pitch and catch to pick up the reception against man coverage.
Both of them read how much yardage they needed, figured what they had to do, and were able to beat the man coverage for the completion.
Throwing, Hundley, and this is going to be incomplete. Carter, your thoughts on this D-line?
I love a unit that can control the run and get after the passer. This is an all-around terrific defensive front. Hard to move the ball against them on the ground, and then when you want to throw it, look out. Here they come after the quarterback.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll wind up with about six up past the 30 to the 31.
But this play sequence was really kind of called in reverse. Incomplete pass on first and 10. Nice run on second and 10 when probably everyone was expecting them to throw the football. Now if you're the defense, what are they going to do on third down? You're a little off balance.
Third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. First down, he'll drop to throw. And it's complete to Ladarius Green. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do. And it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up in the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Ravens offense now, they get set to head back on the field. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went three and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guy's a little bit jumpy.
You do.
Oh, you understand.
In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. It'll be a loss of 10. And it'll bring up second.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Here we go now. Green, 39.
No. Check. Watch it now, Barty.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. And a quick throw here. That's complete. They'll get 9 there as that sets them up better for third down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs as we just saw there.
Third down now following the completed pass. Defense showing blitz.
All right, here we go. 3-19. Detroit!
The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up fourth down. Here's Drew Kayser now as he'll punt it away for the second time. This is taken at the 18. They'll call that a 61-yard punt. He got all of that one. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. So they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, you have periods devoted in practice just for that, because everyone knows how vital it is to put points on the board when you've entered that part of the field. And to come away with nothing, that's difficult for a team to handle.
And difficult, and now we'll see if they can make it less difficult on themselves on this drive. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get about 4 across the 30 to the 32.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, That was what we call a first-level run, and it was stopped by a second-level player.
Now Hundley. And it's caught over the middle by the tight end, Green. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down. On now is the Titans punter, as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. That's taken inside his own 40. And pretty woeful there. Just 23 yards on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Here comes the Raven offense now, ready for another possession. And three and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul searching there.
I would say so. And they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've had to be on the field a lot more than normal, put them in some tough spots. But what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
Second quarter now. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis with you. It's the Ravens who have the football. They've got it second and 4 to start things out.
Here we go.
And they'll go on the ground. And he's brought down. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. And he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers. And they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Now a handoff looking right. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
Well, he's certainly running the ball pretty well on this drive, and all I remember as a secondary guy was if you're making a lot of tackles in a game, that's usually not good for your defense. You've got to figure out how to keep things in front of you because you know there's 3 levels, defensive line, linebackers, and into the secondary. And if the 3rd level's leading your team in tackles, as a general rule, things aren't going so well for your defense.
A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while...
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Ravens are in for 6. And the Ravens lead it 7-0. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. And the Titans getting set to go. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the 3 and out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. It's like, all right, guys, let's shake things up and let's go, because they still have an opportunity to make things happen.
Shake it off. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards, and it'll be 2nd and very short. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Let's go!
And some changes here as the D-line separates some. They'll look to throw now on first down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength in brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Here we go!
Throwing, Hundley. He's going to let this one go deep. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
Well, he decided to air it out a little bit on that play, take a shot downfield, but the coverage was really nice. Able to get a hand in and tip it away.
Now the Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on third down.
Could be a blitzer.
And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. And now here come the Ravens. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. Now they'll run it on the toss. Nowhere to go that time. Might have gotten a yard up to the 25.
And that's the type of play that'll fire up the defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
They'll come out in the pistol. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Ah, yes, the old tip drill works to perfection there.
Ah, you're bringing back great memories. Used to love that drill. And a lot of times in practice, you work on it, not just one tip, but multiple tips, just in case the ball stays in the air for a while, to have an awareness and the ability to go up and grab it, and then you want to get some blocking support and end up in the opposite end zone.
In that tip drill, what do you yell?
For us, it was Oski, okay? Oski
was an interception. For different teams.
Different teams have different ways of doing it. I've heard bingo, jackpot. The worst I ever heard, though, was Frankenstein. You don't want it to be a two-syllable word.
Yeah.
You want to get it right down and go. Oski is really the preferred word.
Oski. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We're back to Baltimore after this. They'll look to throw, but he's going to be wrapped up and driven down. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a third and long.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
Back to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
So much about this game is just understanding.
Yeah, the Titans going to signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
the memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
It's a gain of six, moves them to a manageable third and two situation. And quickly, they get to the line.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved them and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. Taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And they're going to speed things up here.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. Now Hundley. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
Now play number 7 of the drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 10. To throw again. Going to throw deep for the end zone. He dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the left hash, it's a 42-yard attempt. And this one is going to just tuck into the bottom left corner as he gets it to go. And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently we're going to get right back to it. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. It's a short kick taken near the 18. And they're going to have really good starting field position here as that's taken up close to the 40. Out come the Ravens now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Cut back, left sideline, and all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. A great play there, 61 yards, and the Ravens have retaken the lead. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned. Because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Partner, I think the easy thing now would be to just abandon the run and start throwing the football at all costs. But I've been in so many games where it doesn't work running the ball, doesn't work running the ball, and then something pops, and now you get something going. I'm not so sure to just abandon your game plan this early in the second half.
He'll look to throw. Got
A man over the middle, and it's complete. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
And when an offense is doing a nice job selling the play-action pass, a lot of responsibility shifts to the linebackers. They're the ones that have to determine run or pass and get to the proper places on the field.
The completion good for 3, and it's second down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. So he got his hands a little too far outside. The ref caught him, threw the flag. One receiver left, two to the right.
Come on, let's go! White 90! White 90!
Watch the curl!
Throwing, Hundley. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. So he got 3 of 1 tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else.
I think the best offenses love to give the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. And that is incomplete.
But no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the... try and pick it up, but they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation. The head coach relied on his eagle eye in the sky to make the right call and was told to challenge it. And it looks like it's paid off.
And from a coach's standpoint, when you throw that flag, it's probably a pretty tense moment. Here it pays off.
Yeah, you have that little bit of indecision. You throw it where you feel like you're right.
Now a hit and a loose football. There he goes, right side. And they're going to bring this one back. A fumble return touchdown for the Titans. So this defense clicking early in the year, week one, the return for a touchdown.
The organization made a concerted effort in the offseason to improve this defense. I have to say they like the early returns.
So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. It's a short kick taken near the 18. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length,
he rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a return across midfield into the 46-yard line. The Titans' offense now, they get ready to do battle again here. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Here we go!
Now this time he'll look to throw. And now another turnover as this one's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. And the Ravens taking the field. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in it, and let him fling another one. I don't care what the emphasis is in the NFL at any given time. every defense is still going to say their number one goal every game is stop the run. And right now, they're not doing that. And that really chips away at your confidence.
And he is going to lose yardage here. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a third down.
Oftentimes, when a guy has a game like this, he's going to take his offensive line out to dinner afterwards. But after a play like that, he may tell them, instead of getting the steaks, guys, we might have to go for the hot dogs.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. And the offense lining up first and 10.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do, you got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions.
Yeah, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Looking left side, and it's complete. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. And the Ravens have once again taken the lead. He's got it, and it's now a 21-16 lead. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities. It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Back to throw now on second and 10. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Ten yards to go on third. Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And the third down pass falls incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And take it right on the 30. It's a 45-yard punt, but a decent return there of 9 yards. And the Ravens, they'll take over. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
If you love pressure,
we'll
see if they dial it up this drive.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
I know anytime you watch a team run the ball really well, there's a pinball effect, people bouncing off of each other. There's also some things of beauty in there, and you see these nice, explosive, strong runs. And this cat, he knows how to carry the football really well and continually wants the football. Why? He knows the offensive line's going to give him great effort, and he gives great effort himself to finish off runs.
And on second and 10 now, and on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They come out here in the eye. And he'll give it here to his running back.
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. 1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up 3rd and 9. 9 yards to go, it's 3rd down. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Out of the gun now on 3rd down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. Back now in Baltimore. It's the Ravens in control of the football. They've also got the lead as we get set for the 4th. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the right hash, it's a 35-yard attempt. And Tucker's kick right there, it's good. And that'll push the lead up to 8. So, Charles, I think from a defensive perspective, you have to look at that field goal there and consider it a win.
You were able to keep them within a touchdown, so no question about it. That was the kind of stand that keeps you in ball games.
Fielded about 1 yard deep. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Titan offense now working their way back onto the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
Here we go!
Now a play fake here on 1st down. And this one is incomplete. Unable to connect on the 1st down pass play. Now it's 2nd down.
Let's go!
Going to give this time to the tailback. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. A nice job to get 8 there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a 3rd and 2 coming up.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him. Looks like a nickel set here defensively on 3rd and 2.
Yeah, maybe expecting a throw. Now Hundley. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's got the 1st down yardage before being taken down at midfield.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trade in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. 1st down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
A couple down to about the 27.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there.
Ohio! 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 Come on, let's go!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a 3rd down. Well, usually you don't think of the quarterback coming in for a no-gain play, but that's what we had there. Nice tackle.
Yeah, and how about the range, too? Coming from the outside part of the play, moving his way into the inside and making that play happen. No gain for the offense, big play for the defense.
The play-action fake. They'll look to throw. This will be caught inside the 10. 18 yards there, and it'll be a 1st and goal.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
Flush to his right. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll make it 2nd and goal.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Here we go. Pass 38.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. The Ravens' offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
And at this stage of the game, time a factor, time on their side as they just try to eke out the final precious moments of this one. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. Looking middle, and that's complete. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Here we go now. Blue landing.
Now they'll run it on the toss. Yeah, the Titans going to signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So the defense has put them in a tough spot. It's second and long. They come up in an offset eye. And he'll give it here to his running back. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Now another timeout here called by the Titans. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. A dime look defensively here for the Titans on third.
Detroit! Over the line now, Lucky 56! Lucky 56!
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. And a timeout here. Timeout taken, whistles blown. Timeout taken by the receiving team. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. This is brought in at the 21. This one across the 45 before he's brought down. So the D-line's going to spread out. He'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. A gain of six there on first. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. And now they're in the hurry up.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer back.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Titans. A great effort there. 46 yards. And the Titans are within a two-point conversion of tying this game.
And there's the touchdown, partner. We just saw it. What do you do now? Oh, yeah, of course you know what you do. You're going for two, right?
I think anytime you're inside of 2 minutes in this situation. And he's going to be sacked. They came after him. He couldn't get away. And this remains a two-point game. And this one recovered by the hands team for the Ravens. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though. Now this one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
And on the ground they go with a running back. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
But it was stopped on that play. We saw plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
They come out here in the eye.
Blue 90! Blue 90!
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And down inside the 35, he goes to the 32-yard line. That one good for 10 yards. And that is going to set up a third and one. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. And, partner, this first week, this first game that we get to call together, so special every year.
Turn.